Well, this sets the candidates up for a wheel fire.
Yeah.
And it's a pressure-fed fuel into this particular area here. And what we get out of that is the candidate actually responds to a fully blown blaze in this particular part of the aircraft. And it's simulating a hot wheel or a wheel fire on an aircraft. Now, then the candidate then needs to deploy a hose line and with a backup of a dry chemical powder fire extinguisher. And he then applies it in a certain area. Then he's got to apply a safety factor, which is a danger area from the wheels exploding eventually. So he'll combine an agent of dry chemical powder with a dense water spray application of water. And whole idea is cooling as well as the chemical reaction which is taking place with the extinguishment of the fire due to the dry chemical powder. Well, we're going to have a series of fires. So not only will we have external fire, which they'll extinguish before they make entry, here we'll set up a series of fires throughout the aircraft. Now, the team will make access, and as you can see, we've got casualties set up through the aircraft, and that's simulating passengers who haven't been able to evacuate safely. So we make access, we then work through the aircraft with breathing apparatus and a fire hose, we extinguish the fires, and we remove the casualties the best we can, and usually by a rescue ladder. It does get extremely hot in here. We have temperatures upwards of, say, 350 degrees inside this this area.
Even more so than the burning fuel and the phenomenal radiating heat, these firefighters are up against the clock from the point of ignition. There's a critical 90-second window before the fire burns through the fuselage and threatens passengers. So what was the scenario?
Our scenario was a bird strike. We were turned out from a remote location, so we weren't aware what had happened. Upon driving here, we established there was a full-blown engine fire and a ground fire. So we attacked that with our roof monitor, and then we repositioned according to our tactical plan up this end of the aircraft, and then we went on to deploy hose lines and attack it at the appropriate branches.
You really have to make
sure 3 minutes is very critical. We've got to get there and get 90% of that ground fire knocked down, otherwise the integrity of the fuselage is compromised. And that puts a lot of people in danger. So anywhere on the airport, 3 minutes is our time limit.
And what was the strategy here? How did they attack it?
The strategy was with the roof monitor, initial knockdown of 90% of the fire, that's the aim. And then we deploy hose lines. When we get our branches out, we can knock the monitor off and attack it with the branches, specific areas of the fire.
And what were the resources you had, mate? Like how many litres?
10,000 litres of water and 1,200 litres of foam. The foam is mixing with the water tank when it comes out the branch. Create this nice white solution.
What are some of it's obvious, but what are some of the challenges that the boys face when they're tackling something like this? You've got heat and
it's definitely hard work. We've been at it for 2 weeks now and everyone's starting to get a little bit tired. So, it's just try and concentrate. The hose work needs to be nice and tidy so hoses aren't crossing over each other. Make the job as easy as possible, basically, yeah.